A very good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by, as you all know, in the first class of the week, you all learn something new. And in the next class, you all revise what you have learned. This class today for you is a practice class in which you will practice what you learned in the previous class. Before you begin your practice, let us go through some questions. Can you tell what happens with the section option? With the section option, you can divide your paragraph or lines into sections or get them into a box. Besides getting the columns, you can give an indent or margin also on the lines. You can also change the background color. Do you know what is the difference between footnote and endnote? You can apply footnote on any page of your document and you can view them on different pages and can use the same. However, the endnote is applied only to the last page of your document. Do you all know what happens with the change option? Using change, you can see any changes made to your document. If any user makes any changes in the document, then you will be able to see them. These changes will appear in a different kind of formatting. Can you tell what is to be done to remove the shading from the field name? In order to remove the shading from the field name, you will make use of the field shading option. Can you tell why is the text frame used? Using text frame, you can insert a frame one by one on your page. You can write something in the frame. Text frame functions very much like the text box in the sense that you can place it anywhere. Can you tell why are the horizontal rulers used? With the horizontal rulers, you can draw different types or styles of lines on your page, and you can also format them as per your liking. Now, all of you switch on your computers and then open the writer file. Let us now begin today's class. First, type out the paragraph being shown to you. Let us now begin to practice what you learned in the previous class. Firstly, show how will you practice the use of the formatting bar. If you face a problem, then you need to watch the video and practice with its help. Taking the help of this video, let us now practice the use of formatting bar. So, as you know, to format the text on your writer page, the text needs to be selected. So, first of all, select the text that you want to format using any of the methods that has been taught to you. You can use the arrow keys, your mouse or touchpad, and select the lines. We have selected the paragraph. Now, let's take our cursor to the font size and click on the drop down button. Change the font size to 15. Let's also change the writing of the font or the type of font. As you know, when you click on the drop down button here on the writing style, you can click on the one which you like and it gets changed. Once again, let's make some more format changes. So let's select these lines once again, as is being shown in the video. Let's make these lines bold by clicking on the bold option of the format menu bar. Further, let us also use the bullets and numbering option. So bring your pointer here and click on the bullets and numbering option to apply the bullet. Click. After taking the cursor to the next line, click again and you have the bullets and numbering bullets applied on your two lines. Select the top two lines and let's change the color of the font here. So the color of the font is changed. Let's select the last line and change the color of this line also. We select a different color for this line. Let's now select the lines where we had applied the bullets. Let's select both these lines and let's use the underline option here. You can also change the highlighting background color. So this is how you can use the various options on your writer page. Now divide the given paragraph into two pages and show how will you apply and use the footnote and the endnote. If there are any problems in doing this, then watch the video and learn from it. Let us watch this video and see how we can practice the use of the footnote and the endnote. So to apply the footnote and the endnote, let us first divide our written text on this page into two paragraphs or two pages. So we have taken the first two lines on the first page and the other lines in the second page. Let's bring our cursor to the end of the second line on the first page. Press enter, because this is here where we will want to insert a footnote. You can write CS because we want to apply the footnote on this. We want to explain what CS is. After CS, open bracket, close bracket, and then let the cursor be inside the brackets. Go to the insert menu, click on footnote endnote option. From the box which opens, let's select for numbering, let's select character and let's use the character C. So we write the character C here and then click on this box here for special characters so that you can select any special character of your choice. So we are selecting this special character, which is the character for copyright. And then we just click on OK. In the type, we are using footnote. So then we say OK. And you can see that on the first page itself, at the bottom, a footnote gets applied. And you can write what the CS means here. So we are writing computer shiksha. After you have written, when you take your pointer to the symbol here, you can see a hand. It brings you back to where you had applied the footnote. And if you take the pointer here, again it changes to a hand. When you click there, it takes you to the footnote. So you can see that the footnote where you have applied on the page and where the actual footnote is actually linked. So whenever you take the pointer to either the footnote symbol or in the text where you've applied the footnote, you will go directly to that place. To the footnote or to the page. Let's write something more. So we have written IE and then we have put an open bracket. Close bracket and then put our cursor in the middle. You can see footnote, it gets written there, it shows there. Go to insert menu. Choose footnote endnote option. This time for the numbering, let's let it be automatic and type is footnote. We click on OK. So the numbering comes as a footnote and now we can write what we want to explain. If you notice, when we take the cursor to this number, it doesn't change to a hand till we start writing something. Now that we have written that is, and when we bring the cursor there, it changes to hand. So you can see these are also linked. This is now linked to the second footnote that we have applied on this page. Let's take our pointer to the next line by pressing enter. And now we are typing FYI, capital FYI. Again, open bracket, close bracket. Put the cursor in the middle, or the pointer in the middle of the close open bracket and close bracket. Take the pointer to insert option. Go to footnote end note, and this time we'll be selecting the end note. Let the numbering be automatic. Select end note, click on OK. Now you will see that the end note is applied on the last page, or the second page in this file, third page in this file. Here, after the number, we are typing for your information, because FYI stands for your information. Again, when we take the pointer to the number here, it will change to a hand. When we click there, it will take us to where we had applied the end note. And if we click on the end note, it will again change to a hand and take us to the end note. So this is how the end note and the footnote are linked through these symbols. So this is how you can apply the end note and the footnote on your writer page. See, it keeps getting linked. Whenever we click on the footnote, it brings us to the text. And when we click on the symbol on the text, it takes us to the footnote or the end note. Next, show how will you use the section option of the insert menu. Show how will you divide the paragraph into two sections. Watch the video if you have any doubts. Watching this video now, let us once again practice the use of the section option. So to divide the text into sections, we first need to select all the text that we need to divide. Then we take our pointer to the insert menu bar, click there, and then click on the section option. A box opens and it has various options that you can use. First, you need to type in a name for your section. You can type in CS as is being typed in the video, or you can type your own name. Then the next one is for columns. How many columns you want in your sections? One column, two column, five columns. So that is what you can decide. We are keeping it as one column. Then we need to look at the indents. We have selected actually two columns here. Indents is the margin from the spacing from the margin. So the spacing in front of the text and the spacing after the text, which is before section, after section. You can increase or decrease it by clicking on the up arrow or the down arrow. You can change the background color of your section. You can select the color of your choice and click on insert, and that color gets inserted on your section. And you can see that the section has been made in column and the background color has been applied. So this is how you use the section option. Next, show the use of caption on the other page. If you have any doubts, watch the video. Let us now practice the use of the caption, which can be used for an object, image, text, table. So first, let's drag or create an image. So we can use the drawing toolbar. We picked the smiley face and dragged it on our page. Once you have dragged this, now if you want to give a caption for this image, we need to select this image and then take our pointer to the menu bar, insert option, click there, and then click on caption. In this caption, you can give a name First, let's select the category, whether it's a drawing or a table. Then you can select the numbering scheme that you want to use. So we have selected one scheme. Then we can type the caption, what we want to write about this image. So we are saying this is a smiley face. You can, for any of your objects or image or table, you can write what you think is the correct or relevant thing to be said about that image or object, and that becomes the caption. So we've also said oval tool and curve tool being used for this. Drawing. So once we have completed what we want to write, we click on OK and you will see that the caption gets inserted along with your drawing or object or image. So this is how you will use the caption option. Now show the application of text frame in your document in which you should write about your school or about computer shiksha. If you come across a problem, then watch the video and then apply the text frame. Let us now watch this video and see once again how we can practice the use of applying text frame. So to apply the text frame, let's first go to another page of our writer file and keep the cursor at a place like this, as is shown in the video. New line. Then we go to Insert Meno and select the Frame option. As soon as you select that, a box opens up and the first category is Type. So in the type, you can increase the width, the height of the frame that you want to apply. You can change the position where you want to put it, horizontal, then you come to options, you can type the name for your frame, and this is where you can also apply protection. The next option is wrap, so you can have none, or you can apply the wrap before, after, parallel, through, or optimal. So depending on your requirement, you can apply a hyperlink with the hyperlink option. Then we come to borders. So selecting the borders, you can select the line style that you want to use on the border by scrolling up and down. And you can also change the color of the border. Which is down here. You can click on the drop down button. After you have selected the which border you want to apply, then you can select the color. Like this. Then if you go to background, you can apply the background color of your choice on your text frame. And then click on OK and you get your text frame here. Note that using the green buttons on the sides, you can also use the buttons, drag them to increase the size of your text frame. You can change the height and the width from here also. Then you can type your text inside the text frame. As is being shown in the video, we are typing this class is being conducted. You can type whatever text you like of your choice, which is relevant to your writing page or writer page. Also note that if you are making any spelling mistakes, they will be shown by a red curved line. As you can see, computer is wrongly typed. Also shiksha. So if you are making any mistakes, you can always use the spelling and grammar option to correct the spellings and grammar. After you have finished typing, you can select the text that you have typed and then format it. You can change the font size, you can make it bold. So this is how you can use the text frame on the writer page. Now apply the horizontal ruler on the top of the paragraph and after the paragraph on the second page. For clearing any doubts that you may have, watch the video. Let us once again practice applying the horizontal rulers now. So to apply the horizontal ruler, first get your cursor or pointer to the place where you want to apply the horizontal ruler. For instance, here we are coming to the top of the second page and we want to apply the ruler here. So we keep our cursor here. Then take your pointer to the insert menu. Select the horizontal ruler, which is here. Click on it. A box opens where you have many different types of rulers available. So you can choose the one of your choice. You can scroll up and down. Look for the one which you like. Select that. And then click on OK. And you will see that this ruler gets applied at the place where your cursor was. So this is how you will use and apply the horizontal rulers on your writer page. Next, show how will you insert any other file on the second page. Again, if you face a problem, watch the video. Let us now practice the use of the file option. So, if you want to insert another file in your current file, in the file that you are working on, you need to bring your cursor or your pointer to the place where you want to insert that file. Like here, we have just entered a new line on the second page. Now we take our pointer cursor to the insert menu, click there, and then choose the file option. Click on the file option, which is right at the bottom. As you can see in the video, as soon as we choose the file option, a box will open, which is actually giving you the location of the file on your computer. You should know which file you want to insert in your current file and its location. So it could be on the desktop, it could be in downloads, it could be as pictures, wherever it is. So if it is on desktop, you will select that location. Then you will look for your file and then click on open. And you will notice that the file that you wanted to insert, the data from that file has been inserted on your current file. You can see this by scrolling up and down. You can see that it has come at the place where your cursor was and your file has come on the current file. So this is how you can use the file option. Next, you will use the autocorrect feature to correct some spellings. For example, changing CS to computer shiksha. Note that you should not apply autocorrect by alphabets. If you have any problems with this, then watch the video. Let us now watch this video and practice how we apply the autocorrect option. So, in this page, let's come to a place where there is less text so that we can see the use of autocorrect. And let's type something here. Supposing we type CS here, since autocorrect is already on this text of ours in the writer page, CS automatically changes to computer shiksha. If you look at the format menu, go to the format menu, click there, click on autocorrect, and then click on the autocorrect options. You can see that you have the option of typing replace CS with, and it's already there in our word list. That is why it was getting replaced with computer shiksha whenever we type CS. We select that and we can delete that just to see what happens. Click on OK. Now if we type CS, capital CS, small CS, and give space, it does not get replaced by computer shiksha because the autocorrect does not have that word inbuilt. Let's again go to format menu, autocorrect, look at autocorrect options. Let's look at some other words here. So if we type A-C-H-E-I-V-E, it should get replaced with A-C-H-I-E-V-E. So let's close this and see what happens. We type A-C-H-E-I-V-E, give a space, and as soon as we give this space, you can see this word gets corrected to the correct spelling of achieve. So this is how the autocorrect word which is already there can be changed. However, if we are typing A-C-C-R-O-S-S, which is not close to the word in the autocorrect, it won't get changed and it will show a wrong spelling with a red line under it. We are going back to format, autocorrect option, and we are looking for some other word. For instance, we have looked at accident. So if we type the wrong spelling here and give space after the word, you will see that it gets changed to the correct spelling of accident. So whatever word is already defined in autocorrect, it will change that to the correct spelling. We go back to format and select the autocorrect option and then autocorrect option here. And let's once again type in CS, replace CS with computer shiksha. And then we click on new and click on OK. So that once again, this word gets added to our autocorrect list. You can see it has got added. And now again, if we type CS, it gets replaced by computer shiksha. So this is how you can use the autocorrect option on your writer page. Now, all of you go ahead and insert any clip art and bring this to the center of your text. Also, make sure that the text does not get hidden. Now, use the drawing toolbar to make a drawing and show how will you set it as the background of the page. If you have a doubt, watch the video being shown. Let us watch this video and practice the use of the group option. We already have one image. We are using the drawing toolbar to drag a smiley here. And we are also using the drawing toolbar again to select one of the flowcharts and drag it in our writer sheet. So now we have three images. Individually we can work on them, but if we want that the whole group of all these three images should be changed together, then we first select one of the images, keep the shift key pressed and click on the next image keep the shift key pressed, click on the next image, and you can see that all three images have got selected. Go to the format menu, click on group, and as soon as you click on the group option, these are now, all three images are in a group. So if you move them, they will move in a group. Again, go to format, select the group option, and you can select the enter group option. So if you select any of them and apply some changes, the whole group will have the change. So you can once again select all the images using the shift key and the left button of your mouse or touchpad, go to format, go to group, click on group, and now if you move any of these images, you will see the whole group, all three images are moving. If you make any changes on these images, the changes will be reflected on all three images. Right now the whole group is selected. You can move it up or down. If we go and apply color to the inside of one of the images, it gets applied to the entire group. So all three images get the same color. If they continue to be dragged or moved together, this is how you're going to use the group option. If you change the color again, you can see it's a different color. Now if you go to format and go to group option, you will see that nothing is highlighted. That is because we have not selected the group. So we need to first click on that to select, then go to format, go to group, and this time if we click on ungroup, you will notice that all three now images are not as a part of a group. You can actually move them or work on them separately. Once again, we are going to group and ungroup. We are selecting ungroup after selecting the entire group. Now we are working on individual images. You can select individual images as is seen in the video, and you can move or make any changes on the individual images. So go ahead and save your file and then shut down your computer. In today's class, you practiced the use of options of the insert and formatting menu, like section, footnote and endnote, caption, text frame, horizontal rulers, files, movie and sound, autocorrect, arrange, flip, and also the group option. Computer Shiksha is supported by, thank you.